Welcome to the Riverhawks Insider. I'm Derek Brown. After winning the season opener, the Riverhawks have had 2 weeks of losing. First coming from the fourth-ranked Abilene Christian, and second from the Division I team, North Dakota. But the Riverhawks improved their record on the season 2-2 after a close win to Southeastern, 26-24. Blaine McLean has a story with Riverhawks football.
This is Blaine with the Riverhawks Football Report. Last Saturday, Northeastern traveled to Durant to go head-to-head against Southeastern. At 2 minutes and 22 seconds, Northeastern found themselves down one at their own 11. Kicker Drew Patton put in a 20-yard field goal as time expired for Northeastern to win the game. Trey McVay had 126 yards and 2 touchdowns on the game. Patton went 2-for-3 and earned Lone Star Conference North Player of the Week honors.
Thanks, Blaine. After winning their home opener, it was all downhill for the Riverhawks, losing the next two at home. The men's soccer team is now 4-3 on the year. Rick Hamilton has the scoop.
Hello, this is Rick Hamilton with the Riverhawks Insider, and I have the soccer report.
The Riverhawks take their home field against Eastern New Mexico. The Riverhawks bring early pressure with a long throw in. Jose Garcia is able to get the rebound and get his first goal of the year from a bullet from outside the box. But the lead won't last. A 1-2 pass would give Eastern the tying goal from Ishu Kinemitsu, and the Riverhawks try to reclaim the lead with a Josh Hughes shot. But Eastern adding to their lead late in the first half when Cal Herbert gets the long ball and beats the keeper. Herbert gets another shot on goal with only 7 seconds left to go to send his team into the half up 3-1. Matt Murrell trying to keep his team in the game, getting the stop. He had 4 in the game. The Riverhawks try to come back, but are denied on the rebound shot. The Riverhawks would lose 4-1. The Riverhawks host West Texas A&M, and it wasn't pretty. A deep shot from Dominic Furness beats Murrell for a Texas lead. Murrell gets the diving stop and had 9 stops in the game. Furness gets his second goal of the game off a free kick, and with that, Texas leads 2-0. But the Riverhawks keep trying for a comeback. Corey Cipollone gets fouled, but the ref says it's outside the box, so no penalty kick. The Riverhawks couldn't overcome West Texas, losing 2-0.
Thanks, Rick. Men's golf placed 6th at the Muskogee Country Club, which is the 11th annual NSU Golf Classic.
The UFL went underway last Monday, and the opening game was the Dolphins against the Chiefs. Chiefs start the game with the ball and would get the lead with a deeply thrown pass into the open receiver's hands, taking that one all the way. The Chiefs defense able to get their offense back on the field, and the number one pick, Justin Gordon, picks it off. Later in the game, the Dolphins able to show their offense, and Gordon going high and going to the house. But the Chiefs trying to score here. Quarterback has all day. Size, let's throw it. He throws it, and his man comes down with that one. In the red zone, now, the number one, Gordon, proving again why he's number one, going the distance for 6. Chiefs in the red zone again, and boom, at the 1 goes the Chiefs receiver. Chiefs trying to get the comeback, but Gordon says no comeback, almost getting the interceptions. Dolphins hold on and win 19-16. Second game of the night is the Raiders and the Jets. It was a rough start for the Jets, throwing a pick on their first offensive outing. But the Jets did turn it on, and the big guy gets the TD. The Raiders trying to rally, booting around, throws it up, and his guy comes down with it for 6. This time it's the Jets going high into the corner of the end zone, and he comes down with it. Jets able to find the soft spot in the defense for another touchdown. Switch the field here. The Raiders. And they're on the comeback. Jets Big man again for another score. Raiders offense on the field. You hear the whistle here, but a touchdown is given. The Jets' two-minute offense proved themselves, taking the lead late in the game. But the Raiders, less than a minute left in the game, finding a man stopped at the one. As time expires, quarterback moving around, using his legs. But then he would strut into the end zone for the win, 32-29.
Get to a game and support NSU Riverhawks Athletics. NSU student athletes are your friends and classmates. They work hard at what they do, help make the jobs they do even more rewarding. Get to a game, any game. Just get there and bring your support. NSU student athletes are counting on you. Support your Riverhawks and get to a game.
Need something at the last minute? From scantrons to sweatshirts and everything in between, the University Bookstore can take care of it. Located on the first floor of the UC, the University Bookstore has a friendly staff that will help you with all your needs. Don't have cash? No problem. Use your NSU student ID.
Full story from the Northeastern, NSU's award-winning student newspaper. Check out the paper for all your Riverhawks sports action. Browse the advertisements, read your favorite movie review, and find out what students really think in the opinion section. The Northeastern, the one and only source for Riverhawks news and information. Pick up a copy today.
Get behind the headlines and get the whole story from the Northeastern, NSU's only student newspaper. And check out the paper for all your Riverhawk sports information. Get opinion from student journalists, and be sure to examine the advertising from student-friendly telecall businesses. The Northeastern, the one and only source for NSU news and information. Pick up a copy today.
And for our Not Try This at Home segment, Mike York has the story.
For Don't Try This at Home, I'm going to try to show you guys how to not hurt somebody with a metal folding chair. And so at some point, Rick's going to come be my assistant, but I'm not really sure because, you know.
Buddy, you mind if I borrow this for a second?
Thanks, Mike. Here are some upcoming events. That's it for this week's show. Till next time, I'm Derek Brown.